We looked at over 360,000 people who had been pregnant, and 5,784 of them had had one or more autoimmune conditions during pregnancy. We want to emphasize that this study was limited to looking at pregnancies after 20 weeks that resulted in live births, as opposed to other research on early pregnancy loss and stillbirth. And as expected, we found higher risks for preterm birth with autoimmune diseases overall, particularly lupus and antiphospholipid syndrome. But surprisingly, for rheumatoid arthritis and inflammatory bowel disease, after we accounted for diabetes, hypertension, and other chronic conditions, there was not significantly increased risk for preterm birth and low birth weight. This suggests that for RA and IBD, comorbidities may be a more important factor for adverse outcomes than the underlying autoimmune disease. The thing is, there is no average patient. Autoimmune diseases are not all the same, and each patient has a unique medical history. We're learning more about each of these different autoimmune diseases to best inform care for individual patients.
As a rheumatologist, I see many patients with a variety of autoimmune conditions, such as lupus and rheumatoid arthritis, which predominantly affect women. My patients often ask the question, am I at higher risk for adverse pregnancy outcomes? Most often, my response is, we can get through this together with collaboration between all of your healthcare team. This research has given me hope that in some patients, for example, those with rheumatoid arthritis and inflammatory bowel disease, that their outcomes will be better than anticipated. With other patients, such as those with lupus or antiphospholipid syndrome, this reinforces the importance of careful monitoring of both pregnancy and autoimmune disease activity to optimize outcomes. Research is advancing rapidly. We have learned a great deal about autoimmune diseases and whether to stop, continue, or change medications when you are planning a pregnancy or become pregnant. Patients and physicians should know that having an autoimmune condition doesn't necessarily mean you will have a difficult pregnancy or adverse birth outcomes. It is important for patients to work with their entire healthcare team to optimally manage pregnancy, autoimmune disease, and other conditions.